Okay, I'm going to do something a little different. Are any of you afraid of, I mean, can we make a tunnel and play a game?
Yes.
Okay, so I need you to, everybody stand up. Get close together like a group. Let's see how far we see how it works. Okay, just wait a minute. Now what I'm going to do, you guys okay with this? I'm going to put this over. Okay, you guys are going to have to go behind them. Use behind. Back up close. Hey, right there. Come on. You got to be a group. Try that. Let's see. Charlie, can you get behind Mariah, please? Okay. No, you're not going to step. There you go, bud. Okay. Sneaking out of the crowd.
What are we doing?
We're going to make a tunnel.
How?
Well, watch. I'm going to put this over your heads. Are you guys okay with that?
Yes.
It's all right? Okay, my
Haley isn't.
Okay, well. Oh, hang in there, Haley. Help me. Pull this over your heads. Pull it over your heads. Get in closer. Listen, okay? Gordon, listen. You guys have, hey, shh. I'm in charge. Listen, watch. Do you see anything out, listen. Do you see anything outside this veil?
Wait,
stay back, stay in there. Do you see me clearly?
Yes.
No.
How about you, what else do you see?
I see the
Do you see it clearly?
Yeah.
Zoe, listen, do you see it real clear?
No.
No, you don't. You're looking through a veil. You're in a tunnel. Okay, how about looking up? Do you see the lights?
Yeah.
Are they clear?
No.
Thank you very much. So, now you can see, right?
Yeah.
Okay, now you can sit down. Now you can sit down. Right? Now. No, everything was covered.
No, Torin's face only because he's too small.
Lily,
no, you were holding
breakfast. Okay. This example was this. Is it easy to see God?
No.
When I say you can see God, what does that mean? In your heart, or you feel him, you can understand him more, know him better, right? That's up. Sit down, please, Soren. Okay, so we can see God by learning about him more here, and we can see God with our heart, Soren. See God with our heart too, right? So we get to know God, but it's not clear. He's not clear to us. That was the idea. We were kind of in a tunnel, but you could look through the. Look through the veil covering over your face, and you could see the stained glass window, you could see the light, you could see me.
You could see the screen glass.
Right? You could see the screen, but it wasn't clear like you're seeing it now, right? And so that's the point. Until we're with Jesus, we're not going to see things clearly, but we're going to see things a little bit, okay? But that doesn't mean that we can gain a better understanding of God. Doesn't mean that we can't see God more and more and more as we grow to know him. That's what it means. When we know Jesus more and more, we're seeing him more and more. Seeing him means understanding him more and more. Knowing him, loving him, being loved by him. Okay? Having a deeper relationship with him. Okay? But can people that don't know Jesus as their Savior see God or with their heart, with their understanding? No, they can't. What do you need in order to be able to have a relationship or to see Jesus in your life? What do you need?
Jesus.
Yeah, you need Jesus in your heart. See, I kind of gave you a hint, didn't I?
And you need Jesus.
So, we need Jesus. We need Jesus, and we need to be able to read the Bible to teach us things, right? So people that are lost, have never asked Jesus in their heart, don't even get to look through that veil, that covering over your head, like being in the tunnel, just seeing little lights, getting just a little bit of understanding of who God is and what Jesus means to you. Lost people don't have that opportunity, and that's sad. And so we need to be able to share with them what? What did Jesus do for us?
Died.
Died on? He died on the cross and rose again. And what? What happens? The devil knows that. What do we need to do with that?
We need to tell more people about him so they can come and learn about him.
Yep, you need to tell others about Jesus so they can learn about him. So if you believe Jesus died on the cross and was buried and rose from the grave and he's alive today, and you say, God, I know that. Guess who else knows that? The devil knows that. But he's not going to heaven. Because a person needs to say, thank you for dying for my sins. Please forgive me for my sins. Please come live in my heart and be my Lord and Savior. And then he comes and lives in our heart. And then we have the ability to see God, to see understand him, have a relationship with him, and to love him. Okay? So now one last question, and then I'll read the scripture. So as we grow up in Jesus, can we know him better?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
How?
By reading the Bible.
Going to church and listening to his stories. Okay, going to church, listening to his stories. What else, Charlie? How can we know God better?
By learning about him.
By learning about him, right? Okay. No more. You. Go ahead. By praying. Spending time with God in prayer, talking to him a lot. Reading his Bible, learning what the Bible says, and knowing that he lives in your heart, and you follow him. And as you do that, you're going to begin to understand God more, which means you're going to see him more clearly. In your whole life, you have that opportunity to know God more, to see him more clearly, and then when we're with him one day, we're going to see him just as he is. Right? There won't be a veil covering our face. We'll see him very clearly and understand everything. Okay, let me read the scripture to you. In 2 Corinthians 3:15 and 16, it says, but even to this day, when Moses is read, that means the book of Moses, first five books of the Bible, a veil lies on their heart. Nevertheless, when one turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. They're saying even when Moses was alive, or the writings that Moses wrote, the first five books of the Bible, when they would read those people, some people would not understand and their faces were veiled. They just did not see it. They didn't understand what God was saying through the word, right? But it says, but when one turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. As we get closer to Jesus, we can see more clearly. Yeah, the veil is taken away, okay? So, you want to know Jesus more? You read his Bible, you pray, obviously you learn all you can in church, but most importantly, what do you do?
Read the Bible.
What's the most important thing to do to know Jesus?
Ask him in your heart.
Ask him in your heart as your Savior. Amen. Let's go to the Lord, okay? Father, I just thank you for each one. Make sure you close your eyes and pray because we got you on camera. We have proof. We have evidence. Close your eyes. Please. Respect that. Father, thank you for the kids. Help them, Father, to just love you, to grow in understanding of you. Enlighten them. Help them to see you more clearly and to love you more deeply. In Jesus' name, amen. I saw your eyes open.